Today I've got some tips for you guys when designing a letterhead using Adobe Illustrator. So stay tuned and follow along for some great tips for letterhead design. Yo, what is up people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. So today I've got some really cool tips for you guys when you're designing a letterhead using Adobe Illustrator. I'm going to show you guys technical tips as well as tips on the aesthetics of a letterhead design. So today I'm going to briefly walk you through as I design this letterhead in Illustrator and offer you some tips when setting up and designing the letterhead. I'm not going to cover every single design step today to save time. In Illustrator, make a new document and a typical size to use for a letterhead is A4. I'm going to use millimeters because that's what's natural for me to use. And we're going to add a bleed for printing purposes today, so type in 5mm and then click the link icon to add the bleed around the entire page. So here is our document for the letterhead design. However, I'm going to show you guys a nifty technique that you might want to use. If we open up the transform window in Illustrator CC, you're going to be able to control guide placements very easily and precisely. So press Command or Control R to open up the rulers, and then drag across a guide. We can use guides as a kind of margin, so we know where to keep all crucial information of the design inside away from the print edge. I will use 10mm as my margin, so in the transform window, I can type in 10mm into the x-axis, and then hit enter. The guide is now going to be exactly 10mm from the left-hand side. I know A4 is 210mm across, so I can type in 200 for the other side. I will then go ahead and do this for the y-axis guides. So there is your document ready for the letterhead design. But before we continue, I want to give you guys some tips on aesthetics for your artwork. When designing a letterhead, it's crucial that you have a vision beforehand. There are various methods that you can apply. So for example, you might want to choose a minimal graphic at the foot of the letterhead that is on brand with the logo. Another simple technique is to create a band along the left-hand side of the letterhead that is again on point with the color scheme of the brand. Another possibility that you might want to explore is having graphics in opposite corners of your letterhead design. This is also fairly popular. I do like the minimal approach as you can see here. This could be part of a stationary set, if done correctly. And finally, a simple border that is around the edges of your design. But as you can see, there's a running theme throughout, depending on the vision the designer has beforehand. So on with my design today. Like I said, I'm not going to show you every single step, but I'm going to give you guys the most important details. It is a good idea to set a background for your letterhead, so for me today I'm going to use white that I can sample from the canvas with the eyedropper tool. I'm going to use the rectangle tool to cover the entire artboard, all the way up to the bleeds. Remember, your design is going to be cut out along the black borderline, but design your artwork up to the bleed. I will lock the background in place so it doesn't move around throughout the entire design process. I've gone ahead and added the top section of my design here. I decided to go with a black and white chic design, with gold as being a focal point. I really do love black, gold and white as a colour scheme. One thing that I think does look really good and is a good tip for designing a letterhead is to add the logo with a brand name right in the middle of the page in a fairly large manner. However, you're going to want to lower the opacity down to almost zero. This is so the brand name is easily obvious, yet you can still add text all over the entire page and the legibility is not going to be lost. You can add the text elements with the text tool here or press T on your keyboard. The tip that I have for you here is to add multiple text boxes instead of just using one for your entire text. This helps so that you can edit and manipulate different areas of your text independently. For some reason, beginner designers tend to use one text box for all of the text elements. At the top here, you can align your text to the left or the right, which is a must-do for letterhead design. If you press Command or Control T together, you can bring up this window here. You're then going to have quick access to editing the text on your design by changing the leading, the kerning, and the size and so forth. Also, having social media icons looks really, really great on the letterhead, and you can find these vectors in the description below. The guides we set at the very start of the video are here to keep all crucial info away from the print edge, but if you want to hide them, you can control or right click the canvas and then hide the guides. Okay, so finally printing. You want to save two versions of your design. One without text being outlined, so you can actually edit it at a later stage. So save it as an AI format and then label it something like edit. You can package or embed fonts, or you can outline them too. And there's also another way of doing this, which I've learned yesterday, and I'm going to show you guys that in a different video. For now, we want to outline all fonts so that a computer or any printing agency uses will not have issues in recognizing random fonts. When you have outlined the fonts, go up to File, Save As, and then use PDF. Use the newest version of Acrobat and make sure you select the View PDF After Saving option. Compression should be fine by default, and then use the document print settings, as well as these ones here. There is very little to do now apart from actually saving the letterhead as a PDF and then viewing it in Acrobat. Remember that once it's printed, it will be cut along these lines in the corner here, so anything outside of these lines is going to be discarded. So that was my video on letterhead design tips using Adobe Illustrator. You guys can let me know what you thought of today's video in the comment section below, and also like and share my video on social media if you do find my content useful. Have yourself a great weekend, everyone, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.